So in this video, let's talk about lambda function in Excel. So lambda function is a function that returns another function. So let's do an example of that. So with this function, you're gonna provide one or more parameters. So you can name those parameters whatever you like function arguments. So I could do A, and you could keep doing as many as you need. So let's say right now we need just two. So once you provide your list of arguments, then you follow it as the last argument to be the calculation you're going to do using those arguments. So to do an example of that, we could just take that A and let's multiply it by B for now. Let's just keep it simple. So right now we have this lambda function that will accept two parameters and then it will do this calculation. It will multiply those parameters. So how do you use this? So for right now, I'm just gonna hit enter. Now, think about a function in Excel product. For example, if I had three here and four here, I can go with this product function and say, take this, comma, this, close parentheses. So I'm gonna provide those two arguments, three and four, to this product function. And when I hit enter, I'm gonna get my answer, 12. So now we're gonna do that same thing here using this lambda function that I've created. So think about this as this, the function name product without parentheses and this part. So if I wanted to call that product function, then what I do, I open parentheses and provide those two arguments. So the same thing we're gonna do here. If I go here, I can open parentheses, and then I can do this argument, comma, this argument, close parentheses. And if I hit enter, see, I'm gonna get the same 12. So essentially what's happening here, this B5 is going to be A, B6 is going to be B, and then this is our calculation. Now, if you wanted this function to accept, let's say three arguments, then you would do A, B, C, and then we can do some sort of calculation, whatever we're gonna do here. And then finally, now, because we have three arguments in this function, we need to provide that as a parameter. So we'll just do a comma. And for now, I'm gonna link to B7, which is currently empty, which is gonna be like zero. So the answer is zero. But if I add a number here, see, now we have these three numbers multiplied together using this lambda function. So we'll get to actually useful cases on this, but before we get to it, let's actually talk about how we simplify this so we don't have to write this entire crazy formula. So what if I wanted to just, instead of typing this, say multiply 3 or something like that? So what I could do, I could store this function without the actual function call in a name manager. So I can copy this. I'm gonna hit enter for now. I'll go to our formulas and here I'll open name manager. And here we can store different names. Now you may be familiar with this when you store a named range. It's the same box. So what I do here, I click new and paste my formula right here, that lambda formula. And then here I provide the name for this. So I'm gonna call this multiply 3, like this. So you can call it pretty much anything you want. Just make sure there are no special characters in this. And then also that it doesn't interfere with existing functions. So don't name it like sum because sum already exists. So at this point, if I press OK, because I have this named formula, I should be able to just simply go to here. And instead of doing all of this, I can simply just replace this with that name, which is multiply 3, like this, and hit enter. And see, I got the same answer. So now we should be able to use that across the worksheet anywhere else, right? So I can go here and do multiply 3, open parentheses, and again, the same thing. I could take this, times this, maybe times this time. Close parentheses, hit enter, and as you can see, it works. So now we end up basically creating an internal function inside of the spreadsheet that we can use. So now let's see why this would even be useful. So let's do a couple of cases here. So the reason you'll use this is to simplify certain formulas. So sometimes you'll have formulas that just are too busy and difficult to understand, and you could just make a version of it that's a lot easier to work with. Let's say we want something that's gonna get us the first word out of some phrase, like here. So the way we would do this, for example, I could use search function, and I would do find a space, comma, and I would find that space here in this text. So this is going to give me the position of that space, which is 8. Now, if I wanted to get the word machine out of this, then I want to get this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 characters, not including the space, which is the character number 8. So what I would do, I would use left function to do this. So I would do left, and then I would point to this text and then comma, and then say this minus 1, because we want one less character to not include space. So if I had entered, that's gonna give me machine. And here, instead of using this cell B1 as a reference, now I can go back here, grab this search function, cut it out of this, and go back and just paste it right here instead of that B1. And now we got one formula that does this. However, this formula needs more handling. So for example, if I drag this formula down, see, it works for a lot of these, but it doesn't work for this one because this one doesn't have that space. It's just a single word. So I need to handle that. In this case, I probably just want to return that word as is. So I'm going to go back to my formula here. A simple way to handle this, we could just say if error. So if this formula gets an error, then let's just return whatever's already in the cell, like this. And this way, if I drag this down, see, if it's a single word, then it's gonna return that word. We could also handle this in a different way. We could have said, if we search and there is no space, then let's return the word, something like that. But for now, to keep it simple, I'm gonna add one more handling just for these empty cases. So what I'll do, I'll just add if this cell equals blank, comma, then let's just return blank, comma. In all the other cases, we're going to just use this if error. So now it should be a lot cleaner. Let's delete this. Our formula works. It's not really about this formula in particular, but now we have a little more complicated formula that keeps referring to this A1 cell like a bunch of times. Now, how nice would this be if we could just say get first word, open parentheses, and then just click on this, close parentheses, and hit enter, right? Now, obviously it's not gonna work right now because there's no function called get first word. So what we do, we create a lambda function. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy this without the equal sign, hit escape, and here I'm gonna create a lambda function. Here what I'll do, I'll provide a parameter. I'm just gonna say phrase as parameter name, comma. I'm only gonna need one parameter because if you remember, we kept referring to the same A1 cell. So what I'll do here as the calculation after that parameter, I'll just paste that entire formula. And then I'll close parentheses for this whole thing, and that would be my lambda function. Except that instead of saying A1 in this function, I will simply just use this parameter phrase in all those cases. So I'll do phrase for this, phrase for this, phrase for this, and phrase for this. And now this is a lambda function, meaning that I could just open parentheses after this again to call the function, point to the cell, close parentheses, and hit enter. And that should return exactly the same thing. And I could just drag it down and it works the same way. And now, because it's a lambda function, I can just grab this function without the execution part, copy it, hit escape, go to my name manager, and basically just create a new name, paste the function here, and call it get first word, just like that. Press OK. Close this. So now I should be able to just go here and do get first word, open parentheses, click on this, close parentheses, hit enter, and I got my results without having all that complicated stuff in my formula. And just like that, I got this. So hopefully now you can see the power of this. Now let's do another example. Let's say I want another function that's gonna be get last row. And basically what I want to do, I want to be able to just pass a column like this. And when I hit enter, it should tell me what's the last row in this column. Now I want to make sure that gets me the actual last row, meaning that if I have like empty cells in the middle here like this, that should still give me 9. So again, one way we could do this, we could say x match. And as a lookup value, I can basically do something like star question star in quotes, comma. Then I can point to this whole column A, comma. Then I can do this wildcard character match, which is 2, comma. And then finally, I'm going to do search last to first, like this, close parentheses, and hit enter. And as you can see, I got 9, which is the row 9. So if you want to understand exactly how this function works, I have a separate video covering this. Here, I have this function that does what it does. Now I can grab this and convert it to a lambda function. So how do we do that? Again, I'm going to copy that function, hit escape, and then I'm going to do a lambda function. And here we're going to need a parameter. The only parameter we had was this column. So I'll just call it column or range, do a comma, and then I'm going to paste my formula right here. Close parentheses on this, and then I'm going to replace this column with my actual parameter. I'm going to copy that and paste it here. Let's just go this way a little bit. And finally, at this point, I'm not going to call the function anymore. Here, I'll just go straight to creating this. So I'll just copy this whole thing, hit enter, that's fine, and go to my name manager on top here, click new. I'm gonna call this get last row, and I'm just gonna paste my formula right here. Press OK. So now I should have a new function. I can just go here and do equals get last row. Open parentheses, refer to a column like this, close parentheses, hit enter, and I got my 9 without having all of this stuff. So now we have a nice short function that should allow us to get the last row. If I wanted to also use it again, maybe for this column, that's all I have to do to make it happen. And then if I have something different, it should see find whichever one the last row is. And as you can see, this gives me 7, this gives me 9. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.